up, boys and girls? It's 1 o'clock in the afternoon on a Saturday. We're here at Shadyside Dragway. It's kind of Street King event, whatever. Anyway, you got a testing tune and a 3-inch small tire. We may jump the small tire, I don't know. Right now, we're going to get testing. The car's been untested for a while. Haven't uploaded forever. I got a couple. We did do 2 races since I have not uploaded. We got to get back to y'all on that. We'll cover that later in the day. Right now, we're going to do this right here. Just checking out the track. Car's up there. Now, car's there. It's ready to go. They're prepping. As you can see, this is a prep event. There's Knowles. Chase is at home. He's got a girl now. He don't have time for us. We understand. It happens. Welcome back. Hopefully we'll get a good, decent pass today or two, and we'll go from there. Got my preferred type setup. I need to get some practice in here. Make sure the car is good. And I've done it on the street a couple times, but you know, I really, really need to practice. Give it all she can take and see what she does. So we'll go from there.
We had a brief drizzle, it's gone now. That's what we're supposed to do the rest of the day, so we'll have in and out, but it's still blazing hot. They're still prepping. Don't think we'll have anything substantial. It's clear back there. Kind of breaking there, so we'll see how it goes. Hope I get one pass off the NASCAR. So I ain't got nothing. All I've done is maybe sweat 45 pounds of sweat out, so I'm definitely now down with nothing. No water weight left at all.
Alright, that brief thunderstorm has turned into this now. Yeah, okay, cool.
30 minutes.
Once it gets done, we'll have 2 dudes out here with a Wagner paint dryer on the track going after it. And 1 drop cord we'll have to share between each other. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine.
Sun's back out. Blue skies here. Car's dried off. Put some track drop. Hope I can get one or 2 passes in. I just want to get something so I know where I'm at. Which car I'm prepping for. Done hits on the street, know where it's at there. I need to do a no prep hit on the track, but I can wait for that. Today it would be radio prep, and I can see what I can do there. Anytime you do a car and quarter good stuff, I guess a lot of compromises, and the car's a giant compromise, but it is what it is. I just haven't got it like that to set a car up all the way. Nice car there. I have a super nice Mustang back over there. That thing is clean, man. My car like a ball in the junkyard next to that. Cool old 400 cubic inch C4 there with nitrous on it, full exhaust. Double bonus points for full exhaust. I know I don't have full exhaust, so I don't get no bonus points. My friend out here doing some track ride. We'll be right back. thing, you gotta move it. Let's see here. It's obviously the next day, but we're going to go back to the race. So, it finally get cleared out. We go down there, and this is my burnout. Everything was great through the burnout. You hear a bang to rev limiter, but I saw it on there. I snatched it back at another gear. Everything seemed like it was going to go good. Then I pull up to the line. That failed. Big thanks to Boosted, my friend, for the footage. Noel's failed me on that. He said he should be trying to line me up, whatever. I told him I kind of know how to line the car up now. But anyway, neither here nor there. So big thanks to him for the footage. Thank you, sir. Car stumbled. It would hardly come up at that point. It was like it hadn't done that before. I mean, it was done a lot of things in the past. But what I'm trying to say is we had took it out earlier in the week on the street. I'll put a picture here. Marks I left on 3 pounds on the street and rolled in at 14 pounds. And went around 650 on the street there. I got the draggy for it, don't worry about it. It's not that impressive, okay? 650 is not fast, but on a unprepped street up here, I was kind of happy with it. I didn't even back into my burnout spot. I did the burnout roll for it, and I hit it. So I was kind of happy with that, because that's kind of what I'm trying to do. I mean, I'm not trying to be super pro mod guy here, okay? So anywho, car did great, pulled red line, no problems, all right? So yesterday's track, we checked the two-step down at the pits. We took up on the return, high part of the road up there at the Shady Side. If you ever been there, there's 3 levels. The upper road there, you bring Wild West, you go do a little test quick, just make sure you're okay. I brought it up on the two-step and launched it and went through the first 2 gears, no problem. Obviously, it was spinning its brains out, but it went to red line both times. Didn't stutter. Backfired twice on that pass there. You hear it stumble, and it was just not a happy camper. Thought I lost a fuel pump because I have one whining its brains out, but I have fuel pressure, and when I get on the motor and finally get to come over itself, fuel pressure builds. That's not the problem. So brought this out yesterday, fired them up. This one here is 340 degrees running. Sorry, it's gonna go right here. Let me turn it around for you real quick. This cylinder right here, it was like 339, 340. This one was like 190, this one 175, and this one was north 300, I can't remember what it was, okay? So this one's firing, this wasn't firing, and this is definitely firing. I don't want to say not firing, they did have heat in them. You couldn't touch this header, it was hot enough you couldn't touch it, but there's a big heat difference in it, okay? So what we did was we checked the coils, we took the plug wire off with it running, great spark coming out of it, excellent spark, all four of them all the same, okay? So, and this car is so loud it's hard for me to hear, but I took each one of these off and obviously made no difference in the RP in the way it idled, this made no difference in the way it idled. I think this is affected a little bit, and I think this affected a little bit. It's hard for me to tell. One problem is I'm deaf in my left ear, okay? I've got a lot of y'all completely deaf in my left ear, so it's hard for me to hear things sometimes. So diagnosis and certain things like that can be a little bit of a challenge, but I tend to do okay with it. Get that oil off right there before I'm ahead of the smoke. So anyway, today, did a compression test. I didn't put it up, sorry. Did a compression test on it. Let me clean the compression test on it. All four of them are within 2 PSI of each other. Doesn't matter what the pressure is, as long as they're consistency, okay? So I don't care what the gauge says. The gauge say 300, say 50. As long as they're consistent, and I know this one fires and this one fires, the compression's not the problem there. So the only thing I have left is I'm gonna pull the injectors and I'm gonna run up to Sammy. I just messaged him and he said hopefully later today he'll be around the shop and he can clean them. These already been cleaned one time before when he borrowed them. He cleaned them. That's been quite a while back and he cleaned them and they flowed really well. These are 210cc injectors. So we're gonna take them up there. It's not out of the realm of possibility they could have trash, you know? It's just weird how fast that could happen. I mean, the car literally was doing perfect, and now it won't hardly ever, since it's missing these two cylinders, not firing right, it don't want to rev up, it don't want to do nothing. It just sounds like utter crap. But like I said, I pulled all four of these rockers off. All four push rods were the same. They're 7400s like they're supposed to be. They're straight, they're not bent. I verified it with this turning over, you can see the cams moving them up and down. So, gotta be that, and here's the next thing. Let me show you this. These are the plugs, okay? This is number 1, this is number 3, this is number 5, and number 7. Now, I don't know a whole lot, but I know the black ring on the outside, that is generally from idling, okay? Because the car idled at 13.0, 13.5 out at idle, okay? We're not trying to tune this thing for gas mileage. We just want it to be very, very responsive, okay? So it has a little bit of fuel in it at idle. So generally, it's normal to get black rings around it, okay? I can show you tons and tons of plugs like that. Notice how this doesn't have a black ring around it? That one doesn't. That one does. So these are not firing. as in we're not making full combustion in there. And that would probably be a lack of fuel, what that would be if you ask me. So
I said, we got great fuel at the idle. We have 61 PSI. I got able yesterday when I got home on the dash, I could rev it up and I put it up. And I got to 67 PSI at 2,000 RPM. So it is rising. And the regulator is doing what it's supposed to do. Pumps are deep enough at that point. I haven't. I do need to replace one pump because it is just screaming its brains out. But right now, for all purposes, it's doing what it's supposed to do. This car won't even come up on the brake at all right now, where it was doing it like crazy. The other day I drove it and I brought it on the brake four times doing hits all over this neighborhood. I had cops everywhere. It was awesome. But anyhoos, we go ahead and get these injectors out and we're gonna run them up to Sandy and we'll report back to you later in a different video. We're gonna wrap this one up because I think it's way too long now and we'll move on to something else.
Mark my prolonged absence. I'll try to be a little more present in the here and now as long as I have things to record, and I do have something to record right now. Thought I lost the motor yesterday. If I did, I got the aluminum forged one right here. So that's gonna go in before long. I'm wanting to hold off the winter because it's nice weather outside and it's time to be racing. Probably the next video you see, before you see the injector, I'm gonna try to put together what happened the last two times we had, because we've had quite a outstanding, not a fun time the last few times at the track. We'll see what we can come up with. But anyway, peace, chicken grease, and catch y'all later. Thanks for watching. Tell your friends about us. You know what I'm saying? Help out my